Hi, my name is Robert. This video is designed to give you step-by-step detailed instructions on completing the task at hand. Please read the comments in the About section of this video. It has valuable information and updates. My YouTube channel has a disclaimer video that I encourage you to watch. And please, like, share, and subscribe. I hope you found what you're looking for. Thank you very much for watching. I'm going to replace the brakes and rotors on the front of this 2001 Lexus is300. The owner is feeling some pulsating in the braking, just a little bit, but that's enough to irritate them, so I'm gonna go ahead and do it. So what you want to do, you want to block the wheels, set the parking brake, remove the wheels, take the calipers apart, take the caliper bracket off, knock the rotors off, and then you want to go back in, check your suspension parts, put your pads on, lubricate them on the contact point, put your anti-seize on there. And I also, on the caliper mounting bolts, I put a medium strength Loctite. These are the tools you need to replace the pads and rotors on this vehicle. You got your brake lube, a sledgehammer, small or just a regular hammer. Your tools to get the lug nuts loose. You got 17 millimeter, 14 millimeter sockets. You have a extra thin, I don't know if it's a 14 or a 15 millimeter boxed in wrench to hold your gap pin bolts, flat tip screwdriver, breaker bar, 3-inch ratchet. You got your torque wrench, wire brush, brake pads, rotors, cleaners for cleaning any lubrication off the disc. You got lubrication or anti-seize for putting in between the wheel hub and the rotors, make sure they don't get rusted together. You got your C-clamp for compressing the calipers, gloves, rags, scissors, jacks, jack tool, jack stand, liquid wrench if you're in a place that is prone to rust. And I think I said set of gloves. And I use medium strength Loctite. Set the parking brake and block the back wheels. Next thing you want to do is break the lug nuts loose, and I have the key here that's in the glove box for the locks. Kind of obvious why the rotors are warped a little bit. A couple of these lug nuts were super tight, and one or two were a little bit loose. When you unevenly torque them or torque them in the wrong pattern, it'll warp the rotors a little. Okay, jack the wheel up off the ground. With the jack in the proper position, put a jack stand under the car and lower the vehicle onto the jack stand. And the jack stand is supporting it. Go ahead and pull your lug nuts off and remove your wheel. Now with most cars, I would just unbolt the caliper mounting bolt and remove the entire caliper, swap the pads in. But on this vehicle, it's not possible to put the pads in with the caliper together. So my next step is to remove the caliper pad bolts, which is here and here. Lift that part of the caliper off, pull the brake pads out, then I'll take the two mounting bolts off of the entire caliper, which is here and one below. These are 14 millimeter. The main mounting bolts are 17 millimeter. So go ahead and take these two bolts out and then take those two bolts out. Get the caliper off of the rotor. Okay, you want to get something under the caliper that you can rest the caliper on so you're not stressing out the brake line. Got those first two bolts out, the caliper apart, so I'm going to take a pad and use a pad to compress those pistons. But you want to look at the pistons, make sure that the seals are good, not torn or anything. If so, you want to either rebuild them or get some rebuilt ones. Now you want to take these little spring clips off so you can get the pads out before you take those mounting bolts off of the caliper bracket. Now when you put the C-clamp on there to compress the pistons in, you want to make sure that you get both of them compressed. It'll make it easier for putting the new pads on. Don't squeeze them too tight. You don't want to damage the caliper pistons. If for some reason one of them don't compress, you might be a seized piston in the caliper. You want to replace that, so they should go in relatively easy. Now, since I don't know the torque value of this bracket mounting bolts, you could put a torque wrench on there and break it loose with the torque wrench, and see what the torque value pressure was of breaking it loose. That's not an exact science. To figuring out the torque value, it's best to ask a repair place or the parts place, but it can get you close. Now, when you take this rotor off, you want to be careful that you don't bend your dust shield, because it'll be rubbing once you get all that stuff back together. Okay, my new pads do have those springs in there, so make sure you get those in right. And they have anti-squeal pads, so read the instructions, make sure you put those on right. And then you want to grease all of the areas that the pads will touch, because you don't want your brakes squealing or nothing like that. So anywhere that in that caliper frame that these pads will touch, you want to put brake lubricant. And if you want to, you could take the pins out and grease the slide pins as well. So that's the stuff I use to grease those other parts. So make sure this is clean and put those shim pads on to avoid squealing brakes. Now, to clean the caliper track areas out, you could use brake parts cleaner. Use the non-flammable stuff. And now you have your rotor. Your rotor should just pop right off. So this one doesn't seem to be. So let me get a sledge or something and tap it a couple times, break it loose. Okay, the rotor was evidently rusted against the hub, so I turned it while tapping this end of it until it popped loose, because it should just slide right off. So what you want to do when you put your new rotor on is you want to put some anti-seize compound on your hub so that your inside of your rotor doesn't rust against it. Go ahead and compare your old and your new rotor. Make sure the size matches up and the holes on them. But you could just set it in place. And if you suspect that your new rotor has some kind of chemical on the surface of it to stop it from rusting, go ahead and wipe that off with some kind of cleaner, like parts brake cleaner, something like that. And then if you're going to paint them, you want to go ahead and tape them off and only paint this part that sticks up here, black or yellow, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and clean the surface off with a rag and parts brake cleaner and put them in place. Next, I'm going to brush that off with a wire brush and put some anti-seize compound against the hub. Now, once you have the rotor off, you want to go ahead and inspect all of the joints in your suspension, the boots in your steering rack, and look at all the parts. If you see any boots torn or parts that appear to be worn, you want to go ahead and plan on getting those replaced sometime soon. Also, this is a good time to check the tires since you have them off. This one's wearing a little bit on the inner tread. Also, these tires are starting to crack because of the age. Tires have a date on them. There, you might be able to see it. 35th week of 2010. When tires get 5 years old, they're just old enough to be replaced at that point. But whenever you purchase tires, you always want to make sure that nobody's selling you no old tire stock. So, hope you can see that date there. It's the week in the year. Install your caliper brackets and torque those two bolts down. I torqued them down to 65 foot-pounds, but I'm not sure what the proper torque value is. Hopefully somebody will message me that information and I'll list it in the about comments below. I did put a little bit of medium strength Loctite on those bolts. Okay, you pull your guide pin out, lubricate it, make sure you don't destroy your boot there, and then put it all back together so they move in and out smoothly, because that controls the pressure on this outer pad from your caliper. Even though this thing has the anti-squeal shims, I still put my brake grease on there to help prevent it. I just want to reduce any chances of that at all costs. Okay, you put those little clips in place that's on the pad, then set your caliper over top of your pads and bolt them in. I don't know what those torque values are supposed to be, but I'm gonna go ahead and torque them in at about 25 foot-pounds. Okay, now you set the wheel in place, you snug the bolts down, make sure they're snug the whole way around. Then you remove your jack stand, lower the jack until you get pressure on the wheel, about half the suspension pressure, and then you torque your bolts down, and you're supposed to go here, 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 here. Torque them down in the star pattern. You'll lessen your chance of warping your rotors. Torque them all at the same tightness. I normally torque aluminum wheels around 75 foot-pounds. Check the owner's manual, it should tell you. And of course, if you got a locking lug, you need that tool as well. After everything's done, they say you should run your rotors and pads in. Basically, I think that means you want to heat them up. So you drive down the road, brake lightly a few times, and then get up to like 70 or 50 miles an hour, whatever your highway speeds are. Brake hard a few times to warm them up, and then after that they should seat right and go smooth for a long time to come. Now, after you start the car and before you pull off and put it in a gear, pump your brakes a few times to build the pressure back up and seat the calipers back onto the pads, because you compress the calipers and it may take the full travel of the brakes a couple of times to build that pressure back up inside those calipers. Then you want to check your fluid on your brake fluid reservoir, make sure it's good, and go from there. But do be careful when you go to start driving the car for the first time. If you feel that this information was useful, please like it and share it with your social media friends. You can subscribe to my channel so that you will get notifications of future videos that I post. You can follow me on Twitter, and if you need to contact me directly, please visit my website. And if you have any questions, leave them below, and someone or myself will reply to them. Again, thank you very much for watching.